What's going on, guys? Today we're playing the second game of milk outside of a bag. Outside of a bag of milk, outside of it. I don't know how to say it, but you know. We're playing the second game right now, so yeah. I think I'm gonna read the subtitles. I'm just gonna, I guess, put it on the screen and then like chime in if I want to say something, I guess, like commentary. This is pretty fun, man. I played the first game and I really liked it. Well, yeah, I liked it pretty much, and I wanted to try this game, so it definitely looks better than the first one, I'll say that. And we have like a visual representation of what this girl that we're going through her life with looks like, which is nice. I like that. And I do like the story, so it seems pretty interesting so far. This is not what I would do. So sad. I want to talk to this girl, bro. I want to get to know her. So rude, dude. So rude. You apologize to her, bozo. Damn, she don't want to talk to us, bro. Unlucky. I really do love this art style, though. It's so nice. The red and the purple. I love it so much, actually. I think I'm gonna read what this guy says, but I'm not gonna read what she says. You can always imagine your thoughts as something small and swarming, like cockroaches. I don't mind either. Look at this art style, dude. It's so nice. Good job. Now start over. Unstable behavior makes you look bad. So, that doesn't bother you? No. A lot of people act like this. There's nothing shameful about snapping at someone, if you have a reason for that. You did have a reason, didn't you? You'll surely get better, believe me. And now, start over. What do you mean? Fine. Forget about them and go to bed. What were you thinking while laying on the floor? That's the thing. I have no idea. This is weird. Oh. This is pretty creepy, to be honest. Why are you crying? Did you drink milk? What have you done? Here, Drink some milk. We got an achievement. First death. Oh, what? Will you tell me or not? I don't know why I said that like that. You're acting weird. To be honest, I have no idea where to look for them. I guess we'll have to tear the whole place apart. Why? Are you trying to come up with a reason right now? You don't have to tell me if you don't want to. Alright then. So, we need to find a bunch of tiny insects inside a mountain of junk without moving anything, even an inch. My, oh my. Cool point and click adventure, we love it. Bro, honestly, I think I'm just gonna read everything. Maybe not the decisions, but I'm gonna read these. It sounds so fun. It would make it even more interesting. And want to know what's the best part? You'll be the one doing it. Oh yes. I start panicking as soon as I get in a multi-choice situation. I'll just keep changing my mind and end up crying and running away. Do you want that to happen? Come on, don't be so boring. You don't have to bear the whole burden. Asking for help is a reasonable decision, too. Let's begin already. I got to the middle of the room and look around. Where would I hide if I were a tiny firefly? Ah, this is so thrilling. My heart gets warmer from the pleasant anticipation. What? I look down after a moment. A small ball of light and warmth crawls out from under my sweater. Wowie. Whatever. It's a firefly. I carefully grab the firefly. It pleasantly scorching to the touch. I put it on my shoulder. I'm sorry, little guy. Time to come home now. As if it was an order, the firefly slowly drifts up, circles around my head for a bit, and then flies into my ear with the speed of a bullet. It tickles. Yeah. Honestly, I don't know if I should read both or if I just should read one. So I don't know. We'll see. Now we have to flick around. Oh, what the heck is that? Garbage. What is that? I get closer to the waste bin and look inside it with curiosity. Pills, packing, notebook pages, and other garbage. Boring. There's nothing here. Indeed, no self-respecting firefly would hide in a heap of garbage. I think I'm not gonna read anything because I don't think it balances out or whatever. Okay, so we already looked at the pills, we looked at the garbage can, now we can look at the drawer. There's a few stuff we can look at actually. Let's look at this. I think something's there, I don't know. Let's check this. Okay, so we have this thing, this thing, this thing, this thing. The door, let's check this. What is that? Strange. Is it just music? Thank you. my socks right now. It's a bit chilly. Okay, so we search kind of. Wait, no, there's actually a lot to search. Okay, let's keep searching. finish searching. Oh, we don't have to. Do I just finish searching?
Thank you.
An achievement? You won't get it. What is this? Another? Is this like the dream that they're telling? Or maybe she's having a dream. I wake up on a wooden bench. In front of me lies a narrow, dim-lit alley. An awfully familiar road. Where could I have seen it? Finally. I hear a voice coming from the other side. From the side. I turn around and see a boy with a weird expression on his face. You're late. Who are you? The boy blinks in bewilderment. We're not going anywhere like this. Try again. Then he takes a very deep breath. You are late. I stared at him, confused. He stares back, also confused. Sorry? The boy nods, satisfied. See? Much better. Do you have a name? My name is Treska. Treska? I give the brat an evaluating look. He's so young, yet already coming at me with questions like that? None of your business. And besides, will anyone tell me what I'm doing here? Hey, that's rude. It's not like there's somebody else here besides me. Haven't they told you anything? I know all there is to know, for one. About what? You're obliged to escort me to the store. Treska says that and strikes a victory pose. No way, I'm doing that. You do understand that refusal is futile. Well, aren't you full of yourself? I'm serious. I'm not the one who decided that. Do you think I'm delighted with your company? He's weird. Constantly shifting between happiness, sadness, loudness, silence. He's a wacko. And his name is stupid. Are you going or what? You can go. And I need to think. I'd be happy to, but I don't know the way. Treska puts a cunning smile. I bite my lower lip in frustration. I'll be honest with you. I don't like you. He simply bursts out laughing in reply. I do like you, though. Then he grabs my hand without hesitation. I don't even have time to retort. Lead the way. Our trip to the store went fine, if not for the fact that Treska was walking way faster than me. And on the other hand, at times he stopped abruptly and went backwards, studying the ground underneath his feet. In the end, the trip took a lot longer than it should. After reaching the store's doors, we are greeted with a sign. That's 2-O-M-N-H-Y-T? Or maybe that's a Z. Zomenhai. I don't know how to say that. We're closing in 20 minutes. Oh, that's what the sign says. Who had the bright idea to indicate their working hours in this way? They're probably having special staff for this. Somebody who runs to change the sign every 5 minutes. It's convenient. Are you joking? Yeah. You're so annoying. It's much better than being boring. How old are you, by the way? None of your business. Ah. And what's your name? None of your business. I was ready to slap the living hell out of the brat, but a scary-looking man suddenly appeared behind the glass. He's holding a cardboard sign that says, "We're closing in 15 minutes. Let's go. What are we waiting for? Huh? Oh, yeah. After another round of going across the long row of canned products, we realized that we were lost. I can't believe you don't know where they sell milk. Maybe we should ask somebody for directions. Sure. Hey, wait up. Treska lets go of lets go of my hand and walks confidently towards one of the few store's customers. That person is standing with their back to us, studying something on the shelf. Hello, can I? I can't hear neither the second part of his question nor the reply he gets, but my good for nothing friend freezes in place, looks the customer straight in the eye. I hurry towards them. Is he your? The customer talks to me. He speaks with disgust while wearing a scornful expression. Oh, homie's in a trance. If he's yours, please get him away from me. Yes, I'm sorry. I grab Cheska's hand and lead him away. He's still looking at the customer, his mouth ajar and eyes popped out. He's also shaking. Only when we return around the corner, Cheska calms down. What was that? I got scared, he said. What? No, not again. Suddenly, Cheska starts screaming like crazy. I cover his mouth with my hand. His face is burning. He's crying. Can you act normal? You don't understand. Of course I don't. I don't understand anything. Annoying other people is still wrong, though. This is something you don't understand, it seems. You're mean. Who, me? I don't know what's going on, but this is interesting. I assume that this is probably like a dream. Cheska pushes me away and runs off. This is definitely a dream. Drat. At the edge of my vision, I see the store staff hanging a new sign on the door. There you are. I meet Cheska at the cash register. Before that, I managed to visit the milk department after finding out where it was. Hey, you move. I hear an angry voice coming from the other side of a long queue that has formed after Cheska. I squeeze through towards him. What happened? The boy doesn't respond. He just looks at his feet and sniffs. The cashier towers over him. There's a bag of milk lying between them. Is he yours? Yes. Just leave him home next time. People in the queue nod in agreement. Pay for the goods, please. Yes, of course. And the waiting fee? What? You heard me. I did. But it's unheard of. Cheska starts giggling all of a sudden. And for the fact that your son is a retard too. But you heard me. You know what? In a fit of rage, I throw a bank note to the cashier of much higher value than needed, even counting all of the stupid fees, then grab a bag of milk and turn around on my heels. We're leaving, Cheska. We spend the whole trip back in silence. At some point, we end up turning right towards a gas station. There, Cheska finally breaks his silence. Do you like ice cream? No. Okay. I look at the boy's face. A light flickers in his eyes for a brief moment and then goes out. You know? He turns away from the path and walks straight towards the highway. With determination, I stare at his back confused. Weird. It seems like you're not helping me at all. A new playful light flickers in Treska's eyes. Oh. Okay, so she was dreaming. Milk, outside a bag of milk, outside a bag of milk. Game by Nikita. No. Is it over? Really? I guess there's multiple endings or something. There's no way the game could be over, right? Are you serious? I guess I'm just gonna wait through the credits and see what happens. The game is pretty fun. This is really the end. I guess it was really short, but I guess there's like more endings, and this is like just one of them, maybe. Something like that. Don't really know. Animation by Eileen Chrome. Yeah, the animation was really nice. I like the art style a lot. The music was nice too. Can't be done. Why are these going so slow? English translation. Aesthetic dialect. Aesthetic dialect. Special thanks to MD. I can't read. Noah, Kevin, Mike, Silky, Mundo, Crispin, Thrillerp, Ben, Beaver, Fading Glimmer, Spen, Nicholas, Ellie, Fading Glimmer again. I guess that was the end of the game. I'm gonna press continue. Oh, you can't just, that was just the end of the game. Okay, well, I really liked this game. It was pretty short, pretty simple. I really did like the art style a lot. And I'm pretty sure there's different endings. So I might try and play this again and get the other endings, because I don't really know, like, because that cannot be the ending of the entire game. So I definitely am going to make a different video of like what happened, I guess. Different video with different endings. And yeah, if you like this video, like it, consider subscribing. If you like this content, if you want more videos, if you want me to make more videos about this game in particular, find all the endings, leave a comment, like, share. And if you do subscribe, hit the bell so you can see when I post. If I post. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.